Welcome to Toronto Public Library's Fun with STEM at Home. Today, we're going to be looking at the science of bubbles and making our own bubble solution. It's never too early to start having fun with science, technology, engineering, and math. And while this program is aimed at ages 6 to 12, older and younger siblings and kids are welcome to join in. So, let's get started. When you make bubble solution, you'll notice that the recipes have two main ingredients in common, water and soap. This is because the outer shell of a bubble is made up of a sandwich of soap and water molecules. There are two layers of soap molecules forming the bread and a layer of water molecules forming the filling in between. This sandwich then wraps around a pocket of air, creating a bubble. Do you see that shimmer? That's the light refracting off of the soap molecules, like it does off of crystal or glass. So, let's get started with our bubble solution. In order to make the bubble solution, you're going to need a bowl to mix in, a spoon to stir with, measuring cups, water, soap, and oil. Do you know why we're adding the oil to the water and soap? It's because when the water evaporates, it makes the bubble weaker, causing it to pop. By adding in the oil, we're slowing down the evaporation process, which makes the bubble stronger. Other recipes use things like sugar or corn syrup to slow the evaporation process. If you want to explore more about the chemistry of bubbles, you can go online after this program and find some other bubble recipes. Try them out and see which one makes the strongest bubbles. For now, though, we're gonna get a little messy. So check with your adult before you start so that they can approve the place that you're going to mix up the bubbles. Adults, I know this is gonna get messy when you let the kids do the measuring and mixing, but it's a really good experiment for them and will help them learn about science and math. So let them do the mixing, okay? Great. Now that we've got everything we need, we're gonna get started. You're going to measure out half a cup of water and put it in your mixing bowl. I need 1 cup of soap, but I've only got the half measuring cup. So what I'm gonna do is fill it twice because half and half makes one. Great. So now that I've got that in, I just need to add in the oil. And I'm going to add in half a teaspoon of oil. Once that's added in, you're going to mix it up really well. And when it's done, your bubble mix is ready to go. Shall we test it out? Oh, that's right. You need a bubble wand too. If you have pipe cleaner, this is the perfect use for it, as it makes a great bubble wand. But I didn't have any pipe cleaner. So my bubble wands, these are just tin foil that's been scrunched up and rolled up to make a bubble wand. It works really well. You can also use string or toilet paper rolls or rolled up paper. Experiment, see what works. But now that you're ready to go, I have a challenge for you. Can you make the biggest possible bubble you can make? Give it a try. And pause the video while you do. I'll be waiting when you get back. Welcome back. Did you manage to make a really big bubble? Great. So what about another challenge? Can you make a really small bubble? Make the tiniest bubble you can manage. So once again, put me on pause and I'll be here when you get back. Welcome back. Did you manage to make a really small bubble? What did you do differently when you made a big bubble as opposed to a small bubble? Why does a big bubble wand make a bigger bubble? The answer is surface area. A bigger bubble wand has more surface area for the bubble solution, so there's more solution to wrap around a pocket of air, making a bigger bubble. Do you like challenges? Do you think I can give you one more? I want you to see if you can make a bubble that isn't round. See if you can make a square bubble. Once again, put me on pause and I'll be here when you get back. Did you manage to make a bubble that wasn't round? I didn't either. That's because a bubble's surface wants to have the smallest surface area it can. And the most efficient shape to do that and wrap around the air is a sphere. So that's why bubbles are round. Thanks for joining me for Bubble Science. I hope you had fun. If, like me, you have a lot of bubble solution left, there's one more thing you can do. Go around the house with your adult and see what type of things you have that you use on a daily basis that could make good bubble wands. I found a couple earlier. Do you think these things would make good bubble wands? Well, we'll have to see. And see what you can find around the house and test out. So thanks for joining me for today's Fun with STEM program. Check back soon for the more Toronto Public Library Fun with STEM at Home programs. Bye for now!